Welcome to Analytics with Nags. In this video, I'm going to talk about how Azure works. The answer is it works based on the technology called virtualization. So we are going to discuss about how virtualization works. If you're new to this channel, hit the subscribe button and press the bell icon for notification. Let's begin our today's topic. So before talking about virtualization, you need to understand the fact like you have your system, any system, right? Or any computing software requires a system that consists of core parts. So assume this is your system, a server that requires RAM or operating system to run, and then data storage. So these are some of the components, correct? So this is the hardware component of it. So when it comes to cloud, for a single customer, if they want to purchase one hardware, again, another customer, okay, they want to purchase for different hardware configurations, it will be very difficult. So what is running behind the scene is like, you need to understand. The concept behind this is hypervisor. What it does is like it emulates the hardware into a software. Whatever the hardware configuration, RAM, operating system, and the different computing powers, it simulates or acting as a real hardware present, but it virtually creates the different virtual machines with their high configurations. So whatever configuration the user customer one provided, 8 GB RAM for customer one and 16 GB RAM for customer two, it will not create or have allocate the physical 8 GB RAM. Instead, from the hypervisor, purpose is to simulate it or emulate the hardware components into a software, virtual machines it will create. This is the core concept behind any cloud technologies, and Azure also uses the same technology. So physical hardware is not created, even though they have the physical hardware. Say for example, they have 64 GB or 128 GB RAM. I'm pretty much not sure how they allocate the RAM. I'm saying about the concept. So if one user or one customer asks for 8 GB, so from 128 GB, it will create a virtual machine as a software machine, right? So it will have only 8 GB, and from 128 GB, another customer, it will allocate 16 GB. This is the logic behind it. No need to dig too much, but this is what a hypervisor is all about, and this is called a virtualization. So this particular concept is expanded globally. They have set up this kind of hypervisor concept in different data centers across the globe. So data centers typically look like this. These are different servers, one black box here, right? This is one rack and this is one rack, right? So here each server will have its own hypervisor. Each server has the hypervisor which will simulate it, and this is the network switch that gives a connection between the servers, and each rack will have one software called fabric controller. So each rack will have its own fabric controller, right? One rack will have fabric controller. This fabric controller is attached to the orchestrator. So whenever there is some request from the client applications, say for example Azure portal, so orchestrator decides which which rack is available. It chooses the best rack and the server available here, and then create the requested command. So in this case, it can be a virtual machine or create SQL server, whatever may be. So this is how the Azure or cloud technologies work, and this data center is what we will choose while we are choosing which location you want your data or your services to be stored, right? I hope you understand the concept behind how Azure technologies is working. It is essential to understand before working on something what you are working on, how it works. there are a lot of technologies or the concepts behind how this is working, but this gives you overall idea behind how Azure or cloud technologies work. If you like this video, hit the thumbs up button and comment below for queries. Do remember that data is your asset.